Hello, in this video, we will see membrane proteins. We will see different types of membrane proteins, some common features, and their functions. Let's get started. Membrane proteins, as per the name, are proteins that are found at the cell membrane. Broadly, they are of two types, integral membrane proteins and peripherally associated membrane proteins. Integral membrane proteins are embedded within the lipid bilayer. It is very difficult to remove them from the membrane. Peripherally associated proteins, on the other hand, are not embedded in the bilayer. Rather, they are associated with polar head group of membrane lipids or integral proteins. They are very easy to remove. Let's study all the types in more detail. Integral membrane proteins can be of three types. Some proteins are embedded in only one leaflet of the lipid bilayer. Such proteins have only one segment outside the bilayer. They are called monotopic proteins. For example, prostaglandin E synthase found on endoplasmic reticulum is monotopic protein. Some proteins span the bilayer. Such proteins are called transmembrane proteins. Some of them span the membrane only once. They are called single pass or single span transmembrane proteins. Such proteins have two segments outside the membrane and are also called bitopic proteins. For example, insulin receptor is a single pass transmembrane protein. Some transmembrane proteins span the membrane multiple times. They are called multi-span transmembrane proteins. They have more than two segments outside the membrane and are also called polytopic proteins. For example, G protein coupled receptors are multi-span membrane proteins. Now the third subtype, lipid anchored proteins. These proteins are not truly embedded in the membrane. Instead, they are attached to lipid molecule embedded in the bilayer. This binding is covalent, making it difficult to remove them. Examples here are proteins attached to glycosyl phosphatidyl inositol in the outer leaflet and proteins with direct linkage to fatty acid in the inner leaflet. So these were integral membrane proteins. Now the peripherally associated proteins. They are neither embedded within the membrane nor attached to it by covalent bonds. Instead, they are associated with polar head group of membrane lipid or membrane protein. Such proteins are easy to remove from the membrane. Example of peripherally associated protein is cytochrome C that participates in electron transport chain. So these were different types of membrane proteins. Now let's see some common features among them. First is regarding structure. For all the integral proteins, the segment of the protein inside the membrane is largely made up of non-polar amino acids. They are hydrophobic. So they can stay comfortably in the hydrophobic environment inside the lipid bilayer. And this segment is usually alpha helix. The outer segment are largely made up of polar amino acids. They are hydrophilic, which is suitable to stay with water on the both sides of the membrane. Now, second feature regarding the movement of membrane proteins. In the video on biological membrane, we have seen that membrane is actually fluid. Phospholipid molecules in the membrane are moving randomly as what happens in any liquid. This applies to membrane proteins also. When the protein is not attached to anything, it can diffuse freely over the entire surface of the membrane. Although this movement tends to be very slow because protein molecules are bulky and sometimes attached to cytoskeleton. In fact, some proteins can't move at all. So these are some common features of membrane proteins. Now the functions of membrane proteins. First, they can serve as receptors. Lipid insoluble signal molecules cannot pass through the membrane. They relay their signal to the membrane receptors, which in turn transmits it to the interior of the cell. For example, alpha-1 receptor of adrenaline in smooth muscles of arterioles. By stimulating this receptor, adrenaline orders the cell to contract. Second function, as adhesion molecule. Some proteins form physical contact with surrounding extracellular matrix or with neighboring cells. For example, integrins attach the cell to the extracellular matrix and catherines make cell-to-cell contacts. Third, to carry out transmembrane movement. These are various transport proteins. They contribute to movement of water and water-soluble substances across the membrane. For example, sodium channels in the neuron allow the passage of sodium when it is stimulated. In such channels, amino acids towards the center of the channel are polar, so they can stay in contact with water. The amino acids on the outer side are non-polar, so they can stay with non-polar lipids of the membrane. Fourth, they can function as enzymes. For example, various enzymes on luminal side of the intestinal cells. They break down small polysaccharides into single sugars and small polypeptides into single amino acids. Finally, their contribution in intracellular signaling. For example, G proteins. They associate with G protein coupled receptors and participate in signal transduction. So these were all the functions. And this is all about the membrane proteins. Let's have a quick summary. Membrane proteins can be integral membrane proteins or peripheral membrane proteins. Integral proteins are embedded within the lipid bilayer. They can be monotopic, single span or bitopic, multispan or polytopic, and lipid anchored proteins. Peripherally associated proteins are associated with polar head group of membrane lipid or integral protein. Transmembrane segments of membrane proteins are mostly made up of non-polar amino acids, and outer segments are mostly made up of polar amino acids. If not limited by anything, they can diffuse freely over the entire surface of the membrane. They can function as receptors, adhesion molecules, transport proteins, enzymes, and in intracellular signaling. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.